Kwani we ujui? Kwani we ujui you were made for more? Kwani we ujui you?
Jay boy. Need to say, need to praise, in a miracle. Zambi ways of forgiveness, so logical. Toka tene, God is so historical. Wonders umefanya, everyone is so vocal. Many, many more, so I need to flow. Papa, give me more legacy. Wem so, hata bila do, come on, say, need to go. Sina taking the trend, kill Larry Tomato. I make it like day, Papa God is still amazing. Sparks in my life, you are ever, ever blazing. BD will reap, never, ever, never lazing. Greener pastures, kama wale tuko grazing. Peekaboo, I see you, I know you. Peekaboo, I know you, I feel you. Peekaboo, I feel you, I trust you. Peekaboo, I trust you, I'll praise you. Sifa vibes, zote trap, hadi tukigosho. Songa karibu, usikize we kidosho. Askiza wote, tajiri au msoto sige mbahatisha man. Kisi loto, keep old school 3G ka Adidas. Sins, mysteries, ways zote weka minus. Blessings na miracles make me go banana. Injili tutapiga TZ hadi Ghana. I'm here kwa makini ways of life you teach. I'm here at your service what you said I preach. Jan to December kila siku za kalenda. Na shukuru umekuwa na migodu janitenda.
Blessings God amenipa sezi kosa kushukuru. Blessings God amenitoa kurudi sezi dhubutu. Picha alimkana na Judas kasaliti na busu. Alishika kwa tupo ndani fungo kama mahabusu. Salabani alikufa ndo maana niko huru. Kwa damu alisamehe ndo maana na abudu. Anasebadi wachawi wana achana na vudu. Evidence tosha yeye ndo mwana wa Mungu. Usibishane na mimi God anakuwaga alright. Future bila God ni dark hato vae all white. Christ unipa rest devo akileba online. Christ ni mwangaza gizani ana provide light. Mungu siya dhumani wezi mvibe na mapick up lines. Anataka holy vibe read the bible punchlines. Yesu ni mokozi damu yake ni kombozi. Shetani hujifanya chui ndani nje mbuzi. Lakini hanitishi juu sasa nina ujuzi. Soma bible chapa sala kama hapa haniguzi. Shetani akiniona yendo sasa utoka nduki. Abraham acha Isaac Joe pale kuna mbuzi.
Chainza shetani
kwake Christ ni maribon. Amenyokoa jina safi ama ribon. Soma kinipa kila siku is a new dawn. Christ is the real deal. Wachana na demons. Liji
we are God. Here we go. Here we go. Yeah, here we go. Yeah, yeah. Don't you know?
Kwani we ujui you were made for more? Kwani we ujui you were made for made for? Kwani we ujui you were made for more? Kwani we ujui you were made for made for? Kwani we ujui you were made for more? Kwani we ujui you were made for made for? Kwani we ujui you were made for more? Kwani we ujui you were made for made for more? More, made for more, more, more. Made for more, yeah. Made for more, more, more.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Shalom, good afternoon. Today, this is the day that the Lord has made. We shall rejoice and be glad in it, for sure, for sure, for sure. Karibuni sana to today's broadcast of Slice of Today. As long as it's today, you shall get a message. You shall get a message, an encouraging word, a quote, a poem. A blog according to your preference and depending on the platform that you are following. So I would like to welcome you to follow Slice of Today on social media platforms. That is Slice of Today in Telegram, Slice of Today in Twitter, Slice underscore of Today in Instagram, Slice of Today, YouTube and Facebook. Karibuni sana. Even at the end of this broadcast, you shall see an invite. You can inbox my brother to be added to Slice of Today WhatsApp group. You can download Slice of Today app. Lastly, you can follow his blog, Slice of Today, at the end of this broadcast. So that song was Made for More by KJ Twins featuring Lee G. Wasanii kutoka hapa Kitengela. I hope it blesses your life. It has been our theme for the last two broadcasts, and it is a blessing to mine. Let's pray. Our dear Heavenly Father, thank you because of this day. Thank you because of your word. As it comes forth, may it transform our lives. May it leave us better. And we make this prayer in Jesus' mighty name. Amen, amen, and amen. For the last two broadcasts, we have been looking at number one, my call. We said in my call, you are either called by name, you are given a name, or your name is changed. With your call comes your purpose, your assignment. Number two, we have the instruction. With your call comes the instruction. Now, I used the definite article the because it is tailor-made to you. The instruction is yours. It is my call. It's not the call, but it's my call. In my call, there is the instruction, which is actually the mandate that I've been called into doing. We could use an illustration of maybe when you're going to school, we are all told, oh, go study hard, go study hard. So that's the common denominator as to why you're in school. You can engage in co-curricular activities, you can engage in sports, you can be a student leader, you can even go on trips, etc. But what the instruction that you receive from your parents, your sponsors, your guardians, is go study hard. So that is the instruction that comes with your call. Today, I'd like us to look at something which most people like to ignore in regards to your call and your assignment. There is always a prohibition. There is always a but. Let me pick it from there. My mentor puts it this way. He says that we cannot claim that Adam loved Eve. Why? Because he didn't know if there was anything better to be offered. For me to love my spouse, my girlfriend, my wife, it means I forego all others. So my words that I love you, it has a receipt that I've looked at others. They might be prettier, they might be taller, they might be darker or lighter, but I've decided to love you and to stay with you. So there must be an instance or an opportunity for you to do otherwise, for it to be claimed as love, for it to be claimed as obedience, for it to be claimed as honor. If you're not given an opportunity to dishonor, you can't say that I honor my parents. I loved an illustration. I think I am not so sure who made this illustration, but I'm thinking it's the late Ravi Zacharias. He said, when you're living in a story building, let's say it's the 78th floor, and now that's a good thing, but at your balcony you must have rails. The restriction is actually for your good, because without it, when your kid comes and plays at the balcony, they will fall. And be rest assured, no Superman is coming to rescue them. They'll hit the ground. So for you to live in the 74th floor and have a balcony and enjoy the view, you must have rates, you must have restrictions. It helps you to enjoy the view. It helps you, and even it keeps you at ease, that even your kids can go play there, because you know, at our balcony, they cannot remove those rates, those grills, so they can enjoy it. So with your call, however big, great it is, there is a prohibition, there is a restriction, there is a but. Adam cannot claim that, oh Lord, I love you, if there were not the fruit that was at the middle of the garden. If he was not given an opportunity to prove God, that for sure, God, I love you and I am willing even to obey the instruction not to eat of that tree. If it wasn't there, then man would have been a simple robot. But he must be given an opportunity to do otherwise, for it to be assessed and said to be true love and obedience. So in regards to your call, there is an instruction. In that instruction, there is a prohibition. Servants of God in scriptures, you will see, they were given prohibitions. They were told, you can do everything else, but please, don't tackle it, don't do it. David is a man whom the Bible records was after God's own heart. He loved God so much that even God made an everlasting covenant with him that you shall never lack an heir on the throne. But he's given a restriction. Tafadhali, don't build me a temple. Do everything else. Actually, hata unaweza kusanya vifaa vya kujenga hekalu, lakini usijaribu, don't even break the foundation. Is given a restriction, and it was a test, if I can say so. When John the Baptist is being born, in the account of Dr. Luke, the parents are given a very clear and simple instruction. Huyo kijana sinyolewe nywele, na huyo kijana was hair included in that, whatever. Let me read it.
this is Luke 1, let me do 13. But the angel says to him, do not be afraid, Zachariah, for your prayers have been heard, and your wife Elizabeth will bear for you a son, and you shall call his name John, and you will joy, and you will have joy and gladness, and many will rejoice at his birth. For he will be great before the Lord, and he must not drink any wine or strong drink, and he will be filled with the Holy Spirit even from his mother's womb. So the instruction was no strong drink. Samson's instruction was no strong drink, don't cut the hair. The disciples are being called. They are being told, come and I will make you fishers of men. The instruction is, you have forgone something and I will give you something greater. The day that they decided to go back into fishing, it was a vain expedition. It never yielded fruits. A story is told, I heard this from Pastor Mark Motinder of Life Church International, the apostolic house, of one time the Pope is speaking to one of his juniors, I think it was a cardinal. So he's telling the cardinal, you know, we can't make the statement that Peter made, that silver and gold we do not have, because actually you can assess for yourself, we actually have silver and gold. And the cardinal replied to him and said that we also cannot make the statement, but what we have, we give it unto you, because we have the silver and gold, but we do not have the power that comes from on high. So, the second thing I would like you to capture is that you must show what you have foregone. You must show the life that you have foregone. You must show what you have said bye-bye to. You must tell us, what have you left? Show us the nets that you have left behind to be made a fisher of men. I loved something, I think it is Pastor Papi Piana put it in his book, The Profane Accomplishment. He said, it is either him or Pastor Pancras Ngira. I think it is Pastor Papi Piana. He said that out of 10, actually it's not him, I'm trying to recall who it was. Sorry for that. Out of 10 people who can volunteer themselves to be devil worshippers, only like 3 can be picked. The devil actually doesn't pick everyone. If you don't have a skill to offer, if you don't have something to offer, he can't pick you. He'll just be tormenting you, but he can't pick you to be one of his agents. Listen to this. The devil himself has standards you must meet. I don't know how many of you have heard rumors of how people in national schools are being recruited into devil worship, into Freemason, into satanic cults and whatever. They don't go to a school people had 220 marks. They are recruiting engineers, they are recruiting doctors, they are recruiting pilots, they are recruiting people who got maybe A's and the cream de la cream, if I can put it in the secular phrase. The cream, they are cream of society. So you must show us what you have left behind. If you are good for nothing in the world, quote unquote, what are you bringing into the house of God? God is not calling the lazy. He's a master and he wants stewards who can give returns. Praise be to God. So in regards to my call, there is the instruction, definite article there. And in my call, there is the prohibition. There is something that you and myself, now this is personal. I won't go to specifics, I won't go to details, but this is personal. There is something you are called out of to leave. I'm reminded of the scripture, for that reason, for this reason, a man shall leave his father and mother and go and cleave to wife. You must show us what you are leaving behind, what you are detaching yourself from, what you are saying not to. So that is my challenge to you. It was quite short for today. I hope it challenges you. I hope it sticks in your spirit, in Jesus' mighty name. Let us pray. Our dear Master and Father, thank you because of your word regarding the prohibition. I shall take heed in Jesus' mighty name, I do pray. Amen. 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 Shalom.